These are classic questions. How many squares are there in a chessboard? The temptation is to go with choice A. Mm-hmm. I am just changing my choices because there's a large square. So I'm tempted to go with a B. But let's check out whether A or B is the answer or is one of the other choices the answer. Let's get started. Let's take a look at the chessboard. This is a chessboard. How many squares are there? Obviously, each of these is a square. This is a square, square number one, square number two, square number three. So we'll be counting these unit squares, one by one squares. And then we quickly realize also that this entire chessboard is one square. If I went with eight across the width and eight along the length, that is one more. But hold on, is that the only one? I could possibly look at something like this. Is this a square? I picked two across the width and two along the length. That is also a square. So we realized it's not 64 unit squares plus one this large. So neither is the answer 64 nor is the answer 65. We need to count squares all the way from these unit squares, one by one squares, up to 8 by 8 squares. It's not just 1 by 1 and 8 by 8. It's 1 by 1. How many 2 by 2s are there? How many 3 by 3s are there? So on and so forth. Let's get started. Let's start with a 1 by 1. That's the easiest one. How many of them are there? There are 8 across the width, 8 along the length. Therefore, it's 8 by 8, 64 squares. This is known to us. So this is done. The second part, when we are moving to 2 by 2 squares, we'll arrive at a framework using which we can replicate, duplicate it for 3 by 3, 4 by 4 and extrapolate it for all of those. Let's start with the 2 by 2 squares. I'm going to go about it slowly. We'll do it systematically. How many 2 by 2 squares are there? We'll start in this particular row. So across the width, I could have the length as AB. This is the width of one of those. It could very well be BC. It could be CD. I'm looking at the width of the 2 by 2 squares. It could be D, it could be EF, it could be FG, it could be GH. So if I move across the width, how many are possible? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. When it was a 1 by 1 square, we were able to count 8 of them. When the size of the square increased by 1 unit, when it became 2 by 2, the degree of freedom reduced by 1. So now how many do we have across the width? We have only 7. The same is going to happen along the width length also. We'll quickly do that. It's going to be a 1, 2, which is possibly a length for it. It could be a 2, 3, could be a 3, 4, could be a 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8. So how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have across the width, we can move 7 ways. Along the length, we can move 7 ways. So how many 2 by 2 squares are there? We have 7 into 7. Which is equal to 49 such 2 by 2 squares are there. Now, you know how to extrapolate beyond this. How many 3 by 3 squares are there? This is one other thing. We will do it slowly in a systematic way so that like it basically sinks into us what this method is all about. 3 by 3, I'm just going to write the width of all possible squares. It could be an ABC, it could be BCD, it could be CDE, it could be DEF, it could be EFG, or it could be FGH. How many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So when the square size increased to 3 units, we were down from 7 to 6. When it went from 1 to 2, from 8 to 7. From 2 to 3, the width, now how many counts do we have? It's come down from 7 to 6. The same is going to happen along the length. So how many 3 by 3 squares will we have? We'll have 6 into 6, which is equal to 36 of them. Quickly do this 2 by 2 in a printed form. Put it in words, understand it, and then extrapolate and count all of the rest. With the size of the square increasing by 1 unit from 1 by 1 to 2 by 2, the number of squares across the width comes down to 7, and the ones along the length also has come down by 7, come down to 7. So there will be 7 into 7, 49 2 by 2 squares. We did the calculation for 3 by 3 squares also. It will be 6 into 6, 36 of them. 4 by 4 will be 5 into 5, which is equal to 25. 5 by 5 squares, which will be 4 into 4, 16 of them. 6 by 6 squares, 3 into 3, 9 of them. 7 by 7 squares will be 2 into 2, 4 of them. And 8 by 8 square, there is only 1. So how many squares are there? All that we need to do is basically add up all these numbers. 64 plus 49 plus 36 plus 25 plus 16 plus 9 plus 4 plus 1, which is equal to 204 squares are there in a chessboard. You can either manually add it, no sweat at all. Or you can use this formula if you recall this. Sum of the squares of the first n natural numbers is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6, where n is equal to 8. I'm going to leave you with a variant of this question. Try this variant, which is essentially how many rectangles are there in a chessboard? There are a couple of things to watch out. all of these squares are actually rectangles. Any square is also a rectangle. But you could have a rectangle which is actually 2 units by 1 unit. It could be an 8 units by 4 units. All of these are rectangles. Are we going to hand count the way we did it in this case? Or is there some other better method? Post your answers in the comment section of this video for the number of rectangles in a chessboard.